Good evening. Sorry for the slight delay. The Secretary General will start with opening remarks, and then, of course, he'll be happy to take your questions. Secretary General.
Good evening. Ukraine is the most important security issue in Europe today. We have issued a statement which sets out NATO's position. We continue to follow developments in Ukraine very closely. We deplore the tragic loss of life. We welcome the fact that violence has been stopped through negotiations that paved the way for a peaceful outcome. We emphasize the importance of an inclusive political process based on democratic values and respect for human rights, minorities, and the rule of law, which fulfills the democratic aspirations of the entire Ukrainian people. NATO and Ukraine have a distinctive partnership in the NATO-Ukraine Commission, and that remains the framework for our cooperation. NATO will continue to engage with Ukraine and assist with the implementation of reforms. Defense reform and military cooperation remain key priorities. We commend the Ukrainian armed forces for not intervening in the political crisis. In a democracy, it is imperative that the armed forces do not intervene in the political process. We underscore the need to strengthen democratic control over the defense and security sector with effective parliamentary oversight and the robust involvement of civil society. In the context of recent tragic events, transparent, democratic, and accountable institutions are essential to the future of Ukraine. A sovereign, independent, and stable Ukraine, firmly committed to democracy and the rule of law, is key to Euro-Atlantic security. NATO allies will continue to support Ukrainian sovereignty and independence. We will continue to support Ukraine's territorial integrity and democratic development. And we will continue to uphold the principle of inviolability of frontiers. This is in line with our long-standing partnership. And we will continue to discuss our engagement, and I look forward to meeting our Ukrainian partners tomorrow in the NATO-Ukraine Commission. We have also agreed what NATO's focus should be between now and the Wales Summit in September, and how to keep our capabilities strong and our skills sharp. Through our operations, including Libya and Afghanistan, we have identified the areas where our capabilities do not go far enough or too few countries have them. Libya revealed shortfalls in precision-guided munitions, intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance assets, and experts trained to interpret the data they provide. Work has been ongoing, but the economic crisis has not made it any easier. So we need to take a long, hard look at the most effective way to work together to close those gaps. We will also push ahead with our plans to defend against the threats of the future, such as missile and cyber attacks. We also need to make sure that our forces keep the skills that they have learned over two decades of operations. We need to make sure that all our troops, including our special forces, stay able to work together effortlessly and seamlessly. And that includes working with our partners, and it takes ongoing practice. That can only come with constant practice. That is why we will make the Connected Forces Initiative, which is designed to provide that practice, a central part of the Wales Summit. NATO also has vast experience of working together with countries from beyond the alliance to support their security reforms. We have done this in Afghanistan, Iraq, Kosovo, and elsewhere. Capacity building is about stability and about prevention. It helps countries help themselves and therefore allows us to project stability without always having to project forces. With growing instability in our neighbourhood, we must explore what more we can do to help our neighbours prevent crises as they emerge. As we complete our biggest land operation, our ability to project security beyond our borders will increasingly depend on our presence at sea. Our economies depend on sea transport for much of our energy and our trade. It is therefore vital for NATO to make the very best use possible of the maritime capabilities we have, to uphold the freedom of navigation, to deal with the whole range of threats, including piracy, terrorism, and weapons of mass destruction, and to engage with capable partners and help others build up their capacity. Our task is to make sure that NATO is and remains ready and able to face the challenges of the future. And we have taken some important steps today to prepare this with a view to the summit in Wales. And with that, I'm ready to take your questions.